Hi students, today we are going to study practice set 2.6 in which we have word problems depend upon the applications of the quadratic equation. The first example from the practice set 2.6 is the product of the Pragati's age 2 years ago and 3 years hence is 84. Find the age of Pragati. See the question once again. The product of the age of Pragati 2 years ago and 3 years hence is 84. Find the age of Pragati. Here we have given the information about the age of Pragati. So we will consider the age of Pragati as x years late, x be the age of Pragati. By using given condition, what is the given condition? It is given that the product of the Pragati's age 2 years ago and 3 years hence. Hence means after. Here in this example, hence means after. The product of the age of Pragati 2 years ago and 3 years after, that is 84. So we will easily get the age of Pragati 2 years ago, and that is x minus 2 multiplied by the age of Pragati 3 years after or 3 years hence, that is x plus 3, and this product is equal to 84. That is given information. Now we can easily get the quadratic equation from this product, and we will solve this quadratic equation. We have 3 methods in all for solving the quadratic equation. First one is factorization, second one is completing square method, and third one is formula method. We can use any method. So here we will first frame the quadratic equation. X into x, we have to multiply this x plus 3 by this x. So we will first write x into bracket x plus 3. Now we have to multiply the same bracket by this term, that is minus 2. So we will write here minus 2 into the bracket x plus 3, that is equal to 84. Now x into x is x square plus x into 3 is 3x, minus into plus minus 2 into x is 2x, minus into plus minus 2 into 3 is 6, that is equal to 84. Now transfer this 84 to the left side, and then we will take the addition and subtraction of the similar terms. So here x square remains as it is. This is 3x minus 2x is x, and this minus 6 minus 84 is equal to 0. Now we get x square plus x minus 90, it is equal to 0. Now we have to simplify this quadratic equation, and we have to get the value of x. Now here we have to get the factors of 90 such that their product is 90, since the coefficient of square term is 1, 1 into 90 is 90. We have to get the product of 90 such that their difference is 1, and factors are too easy, 9 and 10, 10 and the 90, and difference is 1. But here the difference is positive, so our bigger factor is positive and smaller factor is negative. We have to factorize 90. The factors are 10 and 9. The difference between them should be plus 1. So bigger number is positive and smaller number is negative. Now our factors are positive 10 and negative 9. So we will use these factors here. X square plus 10x minus 9x minus 90 equal to 0. From the first two terms we can take x as common, and inside the bracket x plus 10 is remaining. From the next two terms we can take minus 9 as common, and again x plus 10 is remaining there inside the bracket. Now here we have x plus 10, here we have x plus 10. We will take x plus 10 as common, and into the second bracket x minus 9 is remaining. Now all of you know that if the product of these two brackets or these two terms is 0, when we get the product 0, if and only if one of them is 0. So we will represent x plus 10 is equal to 0 or x minus 9 is equal to 0. So here we get x is equal to minus 10 or x is equal to 9. And as we know that x is the age of Pragati. X is the age of Pragati and age is never be negative, since this value of x is not accepted. This value x is equal to minus 10 is not accepted. Why? Because x is the age of a person and it should not be negative. So here we will write like that, age is never negative. Age is never be negative, therefore x is not equal to minus 10. So we have x is equal to 9 only. We get two values, but one is unaccepted and one is accepted. Why it is unaccepted? Because age is never negative. So the final answer is present age of Pragati. Present age of Pragati is 9 years. Now we can check whether our answer is correct or wrong. See, 2 years ago the age of Pragati 7, 3 years after the age of Pragati 12, and 7 multiplied by 12 is 84. Given condition is get satisfied. It means that our answer is correct. Hi students, this is third example from the practice set 2.6 in the orange garden of Mr. Madhusudan. There are 150 orange trees. The number of trees in each row is 5 more than each column. Find the number of trees in each row and each column with the help of following flowchart. We have given the number of trees in the orange garden, and here we have given the number of trees in each row and each column also. It is given that the number of trees in each row, we know the number of trees in each row, that is 5 more than in each column. Means the number of trees in each row is depend upon the number of trees in each column. But we didn't know how many trees are there in each column. And once we consider the number of trees in each column, then we will easily get the number of trees in each row. And we have given the total number of trees. If we know the number of trees in each column and number of trees in each row, then we will take the multiplication of number of trees in each column and each row, and we will get the total number of trees. So here we have to complete this activity. We have to write the solution in detail also. Here number of trees in each column, that is given x. The number of trees in each column, that is given x. Now the number of trees in each row. So it is given that the number of trees in each row is 5 more than in each column. So here we can write x plus 5. Number of trees in each row, that is equal to x plus 5. And total number of trees, total number of trees, that is given 150. Or we can simply write the multiplication of x multiplied by x plus 5. Total number of trees is nothing but that is the multiplication, that is the product of the number of trees in each column and the number of trees in each row. And you can write here total number of trees is equal to 150, that is given information, and we can write it as x into x plus 5. Then we have to frame the quadratic equation, then we have to find the value of x, then we have to find the number of trees in column and the number of trees in each row. So here we will write 150. Now we will frame the quadratic equation, and then we will get the value of x, and after that we will get the number of trees in each row and each column. So here no need to write late because already it is given that number of trees in each column is x. So here we'll write number of trees in each column, that is equal to x. Then number of trees in each row, number of trees in each row, that is equal to 5 more than the column, so it is x plus 5. And now by using given condition, we have to frame the quadratic equation first. So here we'll write by using given condition. What is the given condition? It is given that there are 150 orange trees are there in the orange garden. So we will take the multiplication of number of trees in each column and the number of trees in each row, and that is equal to total number of trees. So here we will write x multiplied by x plus 5, it is equal to 150, that is the total number of trees. We have x number of trees in each column and we have x plus 5 number of trees in each row, and their multiplication is nothing but total number of trees. So we get x square plus 5x, it is equal to 150. Now we will transfer this 150 to the left side and we will get x square plus 5x minus 150 is equal to 0. That is the required quadratic equation. Frame the quadratic equation, and here we frame the quadratic equation. Now solving this quadratic equation, we have to find the value of x. Solving this quadratic equation, we have to find the value of x. So we will solve this quadratic equation by the factorization method. Here we have to find the factors of 1 multiplied by 150, that is 150 only, such that their difference is 5 and the factors are 15 and 10. The factors are 15 and 10. Since we get the coefficient of middle term by subtraction, so we have to give the sign of middle term to the bigger number and the opposite sign to the smaller number. So the factors are positive 15 and negative 10. We will write these factors here in place of 5x. So here we will write x square plus 15x minus 10x minus 150, that is equals to 0. Now from the first two terms, we will take x as common, into the bracket x plus 15 is remaining, minus we will take 10 common from the these two terms, and we will get x plus 15 inside the bracket, that is equal to 0. Now x plus 15 is taken common, so inside the second bracket we have x minus 10, that is equals to 0. Now product of these two terms is 0, so we can represent it as x plus 15 is equal to 0 or x minus 10 is equal to 0. We have x is equal to minus 15 or we have x is equal to 10. We get two values of x, but one is unacceptable. The one value of the variable is invalid. This minus 15, x is equal to minus 15, that is not acceptable value, because x is the number of trees in each column and number of trees is never be negative. So here we will write number of trees never be negative, number of trees never be negative. Therefore, x is not equal to minus 15, therefore x is equal to 10, means the number of trees in each column, number of trees in each column, that is equal to 10. And now you can simply write the number of trees in each row, that is 5 more, so it is 15. So we will write the answer here, number of trees in each column, number of trees in each column, that is equal to 10, and number of trees in each row, that is equal to 5 more than 10, that is 15. And now you can check whether it satisfies the given condition or not. 10 multiplied by 15, that is 150, means our answer is correct. Example number 4. Vivek is older than Kishore by 5 years. The sum of the reciprocals of their ages is 1 upon 6. Find their present ages. हेयर वी नोज द एज ऑफ विवेक. विवेक इज ओल्डर. ओल्डर मीन्स मोर इन एज. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ओल्डर और वी कैन सिंपली से इट एज एल्डर. बट हेयर इट इज गिवन दैट ओल्डर. ओल्डर मीन्स मोर इन एज और हैविंग मैक्सिमम एज. दैट पर्सन इज कॉल्ड एज ओल्डर पर्सन. सो हेयर विवेक इज ओल्डर देन किशोर बाय 5 years. वी नो द एज ऑफ विवेक. इट इज डिपेंड अपॉन द एज ऑफ किशोर. वी नोज विवेक इज ओल्डर देन किशोर बाय 5 years बट वी डिडेंट नो द एज ऑफ किशोर. सो वी हैव टू यूज द वेरिएबल टू डिनोट द एज ऑफ किशोर एंड देन वी विल ईजीली गेट द एज ऑफ विवेक. एंड द कंडीशन इज सम ऑफ दियर रेसिप्रोकल्स. सम ऑफ द रेसिप्रोकल्स ऑफ दियर एजेस दैट इज 1/6. फाइंड दियर प्रेजेंट एजेस. सो हियर वी विल फर्स्ट कंसिडर द एज ऑफ किशोर. सो वी विल राइट लेट प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ किशोर. प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ किशोर दैट इज इक्वल टू एक्स. एंड नाउ वी विल ईजीली गेट द एज ऑफ विवेक. सो प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ विवेक. प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ विवेक इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस 5 years. एंड नाउ बाय यूजिंग गिवन कंडीशन. बाय यूजिंग गिवन कंडीशन. व्हाट इज द गिवन कंडीशन. इट इज गिवन दैट सम ऑफ द रेसिप्रोकल्स ऑफ दियर एजेस. नाउ वी नो द एजेस ऑफ बोथ द पर्सन्स किशोर एंड विवेक. एंड वी हैव गिवन दैट द सम ऑफ द रेसिप्रोकल्स ऑफ दियर एजेस इज 1/6. सो फर्स्ट वी विल राइट द रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ द एज ऑफ किशोर. द एज ऑफ किशोर इज एक्स एंड इट्स रेसिप्रोकल इज 1/x. रेसिप्रोकल इज इंटरचेंजिंग द न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर. इफ यू हैव इंटरचेंज द न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर ऑफ द गिवन नंबर देन द नंबर विच इज ऑब्टेन्ड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ द गिवन नंबर. हियर वी हैव द एज ऑफ किशोर एक्स. नथिंग इज देयर इन द डिनोमिनेटर मीन्स 1 इज देयर एंड वी राइट रेसिप्रोकल हियर 1/x प्लस. हियर द एज ऑफ विवेक इज एक्स प्लस 5. Nothing is there in the denominator means 1 is there. Now we will write the reciprocal of it that is 1/x + 5. And the sum of the reciprocals of their ages is equal to 1/6. That is the given information. Now simplifying this we will frame the quadratic equation. And by solving that quadratic equation we will get the value of x. Means we will get the ages of both the persons Kishore and Vivek. So here we will simplify this one. Multiplication of denominator to the denominator x into bracket x plus 5 and cross multiplications is to the numerator that is x plus 5 into 1 x plus 5 plus x into 1 is x that is equal to 1/6. This is 2x plus 5 divided by x into x is x square plus x into 5 is 5x that is equal to 1/6. Now take the cross multiplications 1 multiplied by x square plus 5x. As we know that multiplying any number by 1 means we will get the same number. So we will write this product first that is x square plus 5x. It is equal to 6 multiplied by 2x plus 5. Now this is x square plus 5x as it is. It is equal to 6 into 2x that is 12x plus 6 into 5 that is 30. Now transfer both these terms to the left side, we will get the quadratic equation. It is x square plus 5x minus 12x minus 30 equal to 0 and the quadratic equation is x square minus 7x minus 30 is equal to 0. This is the required quadratic equation. And now we have to simplify this quadratic equation by one of the three methods. First one is factorization, second one is completing square method and the third one is formula method. You can use any method here. If it is possible, we will use factorization method. We have to get the factors of 1 into 30 that is 30 such that their difference is 7 and we will easily get that. Now we have to simplify this quadratic equation by factorization method. So we have to find the factors of minus 30 that is 1 into minus 30 it is minus 30. Now we have to get the factors such that their difference is 7 and the factors are 10 and 3. Now we will determine in the signs first. Since our subtraction is negative, so bigger number is negative and smaller one is positive. So we will write these factors in place of minus 7x. So we will get gx square minus 10x plus 3x minus 30 is equal to 0. From the first two terms, we will take x as common. Inside the bracket, x minus 10 is remaining. Plus, we will take 3 as common from the third and fourth term, and we will get x minus 10 inside the bracket again. Now, we will take this x minus 10 common, and now inside the second bracket, we will get x plus 3, that is equals to 0. Now, since the product of these two factors is 0, so maybe the value of x minus 10 is 0 or the value of x plus 3 is 0. So, we will get x is equal to 10 or x is equal to minus 3. We have two values of x. But here x is the present age of Kishore and age is never be negative. Since the age is never negative, we will get x is equal to 10 only. X is equal to minus 3 is not acceptable, or that is invalid value. So here we will write, since the age is never negative, since the age is never negative, x is not equal to minus 3, so x is equal to 10, that is the present age of Kishore, and now you can easily get the present age of Vivek, that is 15 years. So we will write here, present age of Kishore is equals to 10 years, and the present age of Vivek is 5 years older than Kishore, so it is 15 years old. Now check whether these values which we get are satisfying the given quadratic equation or not. It is given that sum of the reciprocals is 1 upon 6. So we will check whether the reciprocal of 10 and the reciprocal of 15, the sum of the reciprocal of 10 and reciprocal of 15 is equal to 1 upon 6 or not. If it is not, then our answer is wrong, and if it is 1 upon 6, then the answer is correct. So we will take example number 5. Example number 5, Suyesh scored 10 marks more in second test than in the first. 5 times the score of second test is the same as the square of the score in the first test. Find his score in the first test. We have given the information of the marks of students in the two different tests. We know the marks of Suyesh in the second test, that is 10 more than the first test, means the marks of the second test are depend upon the marks of the first step, but we didn't know the marks in the first test, so we will consider the variable for the marks in the first test. So here we will write, let x be the marks. Let x be the marks in first test. Let x be the marks in the first test. So the marks in the second test will be x plus 10, that is 10 more than the first test. So here you can write x plus 10 be the marks in second test. Now, the condition, we have to use here condition. What is the given condition? 5 times the score of the second test. 5 times the score of the second test is equal to or is the same as the square of the first. It is equal to same as the square of the score in the first test. So, we will write that part here. See, the 5 times the score of second test by using given condition. What is the given condition? Read once again. 5 times the score of the second test. 5 times the score of the second test is the same as the square of the score in the first test. The score in the first test is x and square of it. 5 times the score of the second test is the same as the square of the score in the first test. And now simplifying this, we will get the quadratic equation, and simplifying the quadratic equation, we will get the value of x, that is the marks in the first test. So here we will simplify this one, 5x plus 50, that is equals to x square, and the quadratic equation is x square minus 5x minus 50 is equal to 0. We transfer both these terms, linear and constant term, to the right side. So we get x square minus 5x minus 50. Nothing is here in the LHS, means we have 0. Now simplify this. We have to get the factors of 50, 1 into 50, that is 50, such that their difference is 5. And the factors are 10 and 5. The factors are 10 and 5. Since our difference is negative, means we get the coefficient of the linear term by subtraction. So we have to put this sign of the linear term to the bigger number and opposite sign to the smaller number. So we have the factors minus 10 and plus 5. So we can write this as x square minus 10x plus 5x minus 50 is equal to 0. We will make the groups of first two and last two terms. From the first two terms we will take x common. So we will get x minus 10 plus we will take 5 common from this third and fourth term, we will get x minus 10 in the bracket, and now x minus 10 is taken common, so inside the second bracket x plus 5 is remaining. Now you can represent it as x minus 10 is equal to 0 or x plus 5 is equal to 0. So we have x is equal to 10 or x is equal to minus 5. Since the x is the number of marks in the first test and number of marks never be negative, so here we will accept this value only. This is invalid value. X is equal to minus 5 is invalid value, because see, x is the marks in the first test and marks never be negative. So here we will write, since marks never be negative, therefore x is not equal to minus 5. So we have x is equal to 10, and that is our final answer. Find his score in the first test, that is the score in the first test, the score in first test is equal to ten, and the second test is 20. Now check whether the marks which we get, these are satisfying this condition or not. If they are satisfying the given condition, then our answer is correct, and if they are not satisfying the given condition, the answer is wrong. See the answer here, the condition 5 multiplied by score in the second test, 5 multiplied by 20, that is 100, and square of the marks in the first test, that is 10 square, is also 100. So condition gets satisfied, means our answer is correct. Now we will take the example number 6. Example number 6, the question is, Mr. Kasam runs a small business of making earthen pots. He makes certain number of pots on a daily basis. Production cost of each pot is rupees 40 more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. If production cost of all pots per day is rupees 600, find the production cost of one pot and number of pots he make per day. Here we have to find two things, that is production cost of one pot and the number of pots he make per day. Since we have to use only one variable, we have to use only one variable because this lesson is quadratic equation. Here we cannot use two variables. We have to use one variable. So you can use one variable for one of them, either for the number of for the production cost of one pot or the number of pots he make per day. So here read once again question. So we will decide, easily decide for which thing we have to use the variable, that we will easily decide. Mr. Kasam runs a small business of making earthen pots. He makes certain number of pots on daily basis. So here we will consider he makes x pots on daily basis, means every day he made x number of pots. Every day he makes x number of pots. Now see this production cost. Production cost of each pot is rupees 40, more than 10 times the number of pots he make in one day. Means this production cost is depend upon the number of pots he make in one day. See, once again read, production cost of each pot is rupees 40, more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. If you know how many pots he make in a day, then you will definitely decide the production cost, because production cost is depend upon the number of pots he make in one day. So here we will use the variable for the number of pots he made in one day, and then we will easily get the production cost. And see the condition: if production cost of all the pots per day is rupees 600, means this is the product of number of pots he make in one day and the production cost of all the pots, that is equal to 600. And you will easily get the quadratic equation, and simplifying that quadratic equation, we will get both the values, that is number of pots he make in one day and the production cost of one pot. So here we have to use the variable for the number of pots he make in one day. So here we will write, let number of pots, let number of pots made in one day is equal to x. Let the number of pots made in one day, that is equal to x. So here we will get the production cost. Production cost of each pot, that is given. See, this production cost of each pot is rupees 40, more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. Production cost is 40, more than, see this is 40 more than, so we add 40. Production cost of each pot is 40, more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. He made x pots in one day, and 10 times of x is 10x. So this is the production cost. Production cost of each pot is equal to 10x plus 40. That is 40 more than 10 times the number of pots he made in one day, and that is 10x plus 40. Now by using given condition, what is the given condition? See here, if production cost of all the pots is rupees 600, production cost of all the pots, how many pots he made in one day? X pots. The production cost of each pot is 10x plus 40, and now we have to get the cost of all the pots he made in a day, that is 600. He made x pots, and the value of each pot is 10x plus 40, means product of these two. These are the number of pots he made in one day, and this is the production cost of each pot, means the product of these two is given 600. So we can write here x multiplied by 10x plus 40, that is equal to 600. Simplifying this, we will get the quadratic equation x into 10x, that is 10x square, plus x into 4t, that is 4tx, it is equal to 600. Transfer 600 to the left side, we will get 10x square plus 4tx minus 600 equal to 0. We will take 10 as common, and then we will transfer it to the right side, or simply divide each and every term by 10. Divide each term by 10. So here we will get x square, 10 4s are 40, so here we will get 4x, and here we will get 60, it is equals to 0. And now we will simplify this quadratic equation. 60 multiplied by 1 is 60, and we have to get the factors of 60, that is minus 60, such that their difference is 4, and the factors are 10 and 6. Product is 60 and difference is 4. So as our difference is positive, see, after we get the coefficient of middle term after subtraction, and it is positive, so we will get the positive sign to the bigger number and the opposite sign to the smaller number. So our factors are plus 10 and minus 6, and here we will use that factors, x square plus 10x minus 6x minus 60 is equals to 0. In place of this linear term, we put these two factors. Now from the first two terms, we take x as common, inside the bracket x plus 10 is remaining, minus, we will take x as common, inside the bracket x plus 10 is remaining, that is equal to 0. We have x plus 10 in the first bracket and x minus 6 into the second bracket. Here we have x plus 10 is equal to 0, or x minus 6 is equal to 0. We have x is equal to minus 10, or we have x is equal to 6. Since x is the number of pots made in one day, this value x is equal to minus 10, that is invalid, unacceptable. We cannot accept this value because x is the number of pots he made in one day, and that should not be never, that should not be negative. Number of pots never be negative, since this value is unacceptable and the acceptable value is 6. So here we can write, number of pots never be negative. Number of pots never negative. Therefore, x is not equal to minus 10. So we have x is equal to 6. That is the number of pots he made in one day. But we have to get one more value, that is production cost of each pot, or production cost of one pot. So here we will write, number of pots he made in one day, number of pots he made in one day is 6. He made 6 pots in a day, and now we have to get the production cost. So we will put 6 here, 6 into 10 is 60, and 60 plus 40 is 100, that is the production cost. Production cost of each pot. Production cost of each pot is rupees 100. We will put the value of x here. 6 in, see, the production cost is 10x plus 40, and x is 6. 6 into 10 is 60 plus 40, 100. So this is all about the sixth example. Since the question is very long, but the answer is not too long, answer is too easy. Just we have to get all these things correctly, which one is dependent of which one. Here production cost is dependent of the number of pots he made in one day, so we consider variable for the number of pots he made in one day, and then we will easily get the production cost, because production cost is depend upon the number of pots he made in one day. And we will easily get from the quadratic equation, and solving this quadratic equation, we get both the values, that is number of pots he made in one day and the production cost of one pot. So we will take next example, example number 7. See, example number 6. The question is, Mr. Kasam runs a small business. of making earthen pots. He makes certain number of pots on a daily basis. Production cost of each pot is rupees 40 more than 10 times the total number of pots he makes in one day. If production cost of all pots per day is rupees 600, find the production cost of one pot and number of pots he makes per day. Here we have to find two things, that is production cost of one pot and the number of pots he makes per day. Since we have to use only one variable, we have to use only one variable because this lesson is quadratic equation. Here we cannot use two variables, we have to use one variable. So you can use one variable for one of them, either for the number of for the production cost of one pot or the number of pots he makes per day. So here read once again question. So we will easily decide for which thing we have to use the variable, that we will easily decide. Mr. Kasam runs a small business of making earthen pots. He makes certain number of pots on daily basis. So here we will consider he makes x pots on daily basis, means every day he made x number of pots. Every day he makes x number of pots. Now see this production cost. Production cost of each pot is rupees 40 more than 10 times the number of pots he make in one day. Means this production cost is depend upon the number of pots he make in one day. See, once again read, production cost of each pot is rupees 40 more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. If you know how many pots he make in a day, then you will definitely decide the production cost, because production cost is depend upon the number of pots he make in one day. So here we will use the variable for the number of pots he made in one day, and then we will easily get the production cost. And see the condition, if production cost of all the pots per day is rupees 600, means this is the product of number of pots he make in one day and the production cost of all the pots, that is equal to 600. And you will easily get the quadratic equation, and simplifying that quadratic equation, we will get both the values, that is number of pots he make in one day and the production cost of one pot. So here we have to use the variable for the number of pots he make in one day. So here we will write, let number of pots, let number of pots made in one day is equal to x. Let the number of pots made in one day, that is equal to x. So here we will get the production cost. Production cost of each pot, that is given. See this, production cost of each pot is rupees 40 more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. Production cost is 40 more than, see this is 40 more than, so we add 40. Production cost of each pot is 40 more than 10 times the total number of pots he make in one day. He made x pots in one day, and 10 times of x is 10x. So this is the production cost. Production cost of each pot is equal to 10x plus 40. That is 40 more than 10 times the number of pots he made in one day, and that is 10x plus 40. Now by using given condition, what is the given condition? See here, if production cost of all the pots is rupees 600, प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट ऑफ ऑल द पॉट्स, हाउ मेनी पॉट्स ही मेड इन वन डे, एक्स पॉट्स. द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट ऑफ ईच पॉट इज 10x + 40. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू गेट द कॉस्ट ऑफ ऑल द पॉट्स ही मेड इन अ डे, दैट इज 600. ही मेड एक्स पॉट्स एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ईच पॉट इज 10x + 40, मीन्स प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज टू. These are the number of pots he made in one day, and this is the production cost of each pot, means the product of these two is given 600. So we can write here x multiplied by 10x + 40, that is equal to 600. Simplifying this, we will get the quadratic equation x into 10x, that is 10x² plus x into 40, that is 40x, it is equal to 600. Transfer 600 to the left side, we will get 10x² plus 40x minus 600 equal to 0. We will take 10 as common, and then we will transfer it to the right side, or simply divide each and every term by 10. Divide each term by 10. So here we will get x². 10 fours are 40, so here we will get 4x, and here we will get 60 is equals to 0. And now we will simplify this quadratic equation. 60 multiplied by 1 is 60, and we have to get the factors of 60, that is minus 60, such that their difference is 4. Such that their difference is 4, and the factors are 10 and 6. Product is 60 and difference is 4. So, as our difference is positive, see, after we get the coefficient of middle term after subtraction, and it is positive, so we will get the positive sign to the bigger number and the opposite sign to the smaller number. So our factors are +10 and -6, and here we will use that factors x² + 10x - 6x - 60 is equals to 0. In place of this linear term, we put these two factors. Now from the first two terms, we take x as common, inside the bracket x + 10 is remaining, minus we will take x as common, inside the bracket x + 10 is remaining, that is equal to 0. We have x + 10 in the first bracket and x - 6 into the second bracket. Here we have x + 10 is equals to 0, or x - 6 is equal to 0. We have x is equal to -10, or we have x is equal to 6. Since x is the number of pots made in one day, this value x is equal to -10, that is invalid, unacceptable. We cannot accept this value, because x is the number of pots he made in one day, and that should not be never, that should not be negative. Number of pots never be negative, since this value is unacceptable and the acceptable value is 6. So here we can write number of pots never be negative. Number of pots never negative, therefore x is not equal to -10, so we have x is equal to 6, that is the number of pots he made in one day. But we have to get one more value, that is production cost of each pot, or production cost of one pot. So here we will write number of pots he made in one day. Number of pots he made in one day is 6. He made 6 pots in a day, and now we have to get the production cost. So we will put 6 here, 6 into 10 is 60, and 60 plus 40 is 100, that is the production cost. Production cost of each pot. Production cost of each pot is ₹100. We will put the value of x here, 6 in, see, the production cost is 10x plus 40 and x is 6. 6 into 10 is 60 plus 40, 100. So, this is all about the 6th example. Since the question is very long, but the answer is not too long, answer is too easy. Just we have to get all these things correctly, which one is dependent of which one. Here production cost is dependent of the number of pots he made in one day. So we consider variable for the number of pots he made in one day, and then we will easily get the production cost, because production cost is depend upon the number of pots he made in one day. And we will easily get from the quadratic equation, and solving this quadratic equation we get both the values, that is number of pots he made in one day and the production cost of one pot. So we will take next example, example number 7. Example number 7 from practice set 2.6. Pratik takes 8 hours to travel 36 km downstream and return to the same spot. The speed of boat in still water is 12 km per hour. Find the speed of water current. Actually, we solve the examples like this in linear equation into variable also. But here we have to use only one variable, and in that lesson we have to use two variables for two different things. There we have speed of boat in still water, that is also not given, and the speed of water current is also not given. So we have to use two values for two things there in linear equation into variables. But in this example, in the quadratic equation, we have to use one variable and find the speed of water current, that is the question. Means definitely we have to use the variable for the speed of water current. But here we have to take care about the two things. Once again read the question. Pratik takes 8 hours to travel 36 km downstream in the direction of stream, that is called as downstream, and into the opposite direction, that is called as upstream. Here that word is not given, upstream. Pratik take 8 hours to travel 36 km downstream and return to the same spot. Means he traveled upstream also. While returning to the same spot, he is traveling towards upstream. So we have to take care about that. While he is traveling towards downstream, the actual speed is different. Means suppose, see here, he travels downstream. Downstream means into the direction of stream. At that time the addition of the speeds, addition of the two speeds, see, the speed of boat is different and the speed of stream is different, and while traveling downstream, at that time the actual speed is nothing but that is the sum of both the speed, that is the speed of boat in still water and the speed of the water current. Actual speed is the sum of the speed of the boat in still water and the speed of the water current. That is the actual speed while traveling downstream. And now he has to return to the same spot in how many hours? In 8 hours. He travels 36 km downstream and return. Return means again he travels 36 km but upstream. While returning, he travel the same distance, that is 36 km, but it is in the opposite direction of stream, that is called as upstream. And at that time, while traveling in the opposite direction of stream, at that time we have to take the actual speed as the difference between the speed of the boat and the speed of the water current. That is the important thing in this example. While traveling downstream, actual speed is sum of the speed of boat and the speed of water current. And while traveling upstream, at that time actual speed is nothing but that is the difference between the speed of boat and the speed of water current. That is very important thing. Here we have to use the variable for the speed of water current. There we do not have any problem, but while preparing the conditions, while framing the quadratic equation, at that time we have to think about the actual downstream speed and actual upstream speed. While traveling downstream, at that time the sum of both the speeds, एंड वाइल ट्रेवलिंग अप स्ट्रीम एट दैट टाइम वी हैव टू टेक द डिफरेंस ऑफ द बोथ द स्पीड्स. सो हियर वी विल फर्स्ट कंसिडर द स्पीड ऑफ द वॉटर करंट. हियर वील राइट लेट x किलोमीटर पर आवर बी द स्पीड ऑफ वॉटर करंट. बी द स्पीड ऑफ वॉटर करंट. Now we have to get the actual speed traveling downstream and actual speed traveling upstream. Actually upstream word is not given there, but they gives he returns to the same spot. While returning we have to think about the upstream. So here we will write both the actual speeds while traveling downstream and traveling upstream. Actual speed actual speed traveling downstream means into the direction of stream. While traveling into the direction of stream we have to take the addition of both the speeds. See, the speed of water current is x and the speed of the boat is 12 km per hour. That is given information. Speed of the boat in still water is given 12 km per hour, and here we have to represent since 12 is greater than x. What is x? X is the speed of water current and it should be less than the speed of the boat. If the speed of the boat is less and speed of the water current is more, then we cannot travels. We are unable to travel. So here we have to take care about this thing. 12 is greater than x. While subtracting, we have to subtract the smaller number from the bigger one. At that time, we have to know that this 12 is greater than x, and we have to subtract x from 12. While taking addition, that is not necessary. If we write 12 plus x or x plus 12, the addition is same, but while taking subtraction at that time we have to take care about this thing, that is speed of boat is more than speed of the water current. So here actual speed while traveling downstream means we have to take the addition of both the speed, that is speed of boat and speed of water current, kilometer per hour. And now actual speed while traveling upstream, or simply you can write actual speed while returning. Actual speed while he is returning to the same spot. Actual speed while traveling upstream, or simply we can write returning. That is equal to, now here we have to take difference. But while taking difference, we have to subtract the smaller speed from the bigger speed. And here the speed of boat is bigger than the speed of the water current. So here we have to write 12 minus x kilometer per hour. Now we have given the time. Pratik takes 8 hours. That is very important thing. We have given the time. All over time, traveling upstream and downstream means for all the traveling, he take 8 hours. And how to find the time? All of you know that time is equal to distance divided by speed. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. Using that formula, we have to get both the timings. Time while traveling upstream and time while traveling downstream, and then their sum is 8 hours. So here we will use the formula. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. Using that formula we will get both the times, time for the for traveling downstream and the time used for traveling upstream, and their sum is 8 hours. That is given information, or that is the given condition. So here we will get by using given condition the time required for traveling downstream and return, that is 8 hours. So we will first get the time traveling downstream. See, distance divided by speed, time is equal to distance divided by speed. See, for downstream, time is equal to distance is 36 divided by speed is actual speed while traveling downstream, that is 12 plus x. So, here we will write, this is 36 distance divided by speed is 12 plus x. This is the time when he travels downstream. This is the time required when he travels downstream. And now we have to get the time which he required to return or to the upstream, we can say. And the distance is same, 36. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. While he is returning, at that time the distance is same, 36 kilometers. But the actual speed is not the same. The actual speed is actual speed while traveling upstream, that is 12 minus x. So, distance divided by speed, that is the timing. This is the time required for traveling downstream. This is the time required for traveling upstream. And the total time he required, that is 8 hours. The total time he required, that is equal to 8 hours. So, this is the equation by using given condition. Now, we have to convert it into the quadratic equation. We have to frame the quadratic equation. Now, here we will take the addition, multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is into the first bracket 12 plus x into the second bracket 12 minus x. Cross multiplications, 36 multiplied by 12 minus x plus 36 multiplied by 12 plus x, and that is equals to 8. Nothing is there in the denominator, means we can write 1 there. It is not necessary to write 1. We will calculate the numbers into the numerator. This is 36 multiplied by 12, that is 12 6 is 72, 7 carry 12 3 is 36 plus 7 is 43. 432 minus 36x plus, this is 36 multiplied by 12, it is again 432, and plus 36 multiplied by x, that is 36x upon, this is a plus b into a minus b, and that is a square minus b square, 12 square minus x square, that is equal to 8. Nothing is there in the denominator, means 1 is there. Minus 36x plus 36x gets cancelled. 432 plus 432, that is 864 divided by, this is 144 minus x square, that is equal to 8 upon 1. Now, cross multiplications, 8 multiplied by 144, or simply we can write 8 into the bracket 144 minus x square, that is equal to 864. Now, simply we can transfer this 8 to the right side, and we will get 144 minus x square is equal to 864 upon 8. This is 144 minus x square, it is equal to, this is 8 1 is 8, 8 0 is 0, 8 8 is 64, that is 108. Now, transfer both these terms to the right side, and we will get minus x square transferred to the right side plus x square, this 108 as it is. 144 transferred to the right side, it is minus 144, that is equals to 0. This is x square minus 36 is equal to 0. We can write it as x square is equal to 36, and taking square root of both the sides, we will get x is equal to plus or minus 6. Here we get two values of x, that is x is equal to 6 or x is equal to minus 6, but x is speed of the water current. X is speed of the water current, and that should not be negative. Speed is never negative, since speed is never negative. We will write here x is not equal to minus 6, therefore we have x is equal to 6, and the final answer, that is speed of the water current, speed of water current, that is 6 kilometer per hour, speed of water current is 6 kilometer per hour. This is all about the
एग्जाम्पल नंबर सेवन, हियर वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट दीज टू थिंग्स, दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एक्चुअल स्पीड वाइल ट्रैवलिंग डाउन स्ट्रीम एंड एक्चुअल स्पीड वाइल ट्रैवलिंग अप स्ट्रीम, एंड द सेम कंसेप्ट वी हैव यूज इन द लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल ऑल्सो, बट देयर वी डू नॉट हैव बोथ द स्पीड्स, एंड हियर वी हैव गिवन वन स्पीड एंड वी हैव टू गेट द अनदर स्पीड. वी विल टेक नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल.